Does your furry friend take over your bed every night? It's time to reclaim your space while giving them the comfort they deserve with the coldest cozy dog bed. Don't wait. Check out the link in the video description to buy now on Amazon.
At least 300 migrants, including a baby and several children, arrived at the port of Dover on Monday after being rescued crossing the channel by UK Border Force ships. Several children wrapped in towels and wearing life jackets were seen by onlookers, as well as a baby being carried by an adult man. There was a large operation underway all day involving both French and British ships collaborating to rescue people that were seeking to cross the channel on small boats. 843 people have arrived in July this way. This year, 14,232 people have arrived in 283 boats, with 18 deaths since January, including for last Friday. Several children wrapped in towels and wearing life jackets were seen by onlookers in Dover, as well as a baby being carried by an adult man. All Border Force vessels are now back at harbor. The Hurricane, Volunteer, Defender and Typhoon are based in Ramsgate, while the Ranger returned to Dover where it could be seen dropping off more migrants. Today marks the fifth consecutive day of crossings. 127 people in two boats crossed the 21-mile voyage on Saturday, while 41 people arrived in one boat on Sunday. In recent months, migrants have taken longer, riskier routes to evade authorities. One group of Border Force vessels and a French ship were seen along the usual migrant passage, around halfway between Calais and Dover at the narrowest point of the channel. British boats Hurricane and Ranger, along with French boat Mink, operated around 16 miles from Dover. It is unclear if more migrants are attempting the crossing via these two routes. The Mail on Sunday revealed yesterday that beefed-up anti-terrorism laws will be used to try to tackle the small boats crisis, under plans to be unveiled by the government in the King's Speech. More than 1,000 small boat migrants have reached Britain since Labour took power. Home Secretary Yvette Cooper intends to use Labour's thumping Commons majority to extend powers under the Terrorism Act to organised immigration crime, and she is now headhunting a former top spy, such as Sir Alexander Younger, the ex-MI6 chief, to fill the role of border security commander. Ms. Cooper is also planning to increase by 50% the number of specialist officers from Britain's National Crime Agency, NCA, stationed within Europol, the EU's crime-fighting agency, as part of the new drive. A Home Office statement said, "Everyone wants to see an end to the dangerous small boat crossings. They are undermining our border security and putting lives at risk. We are taking action to smash the people smuggling gangs responsible for this trade, establishing a new border security command to bring together our intelligence and enforcement agencies, equipped with new counter-terror-style powers and hundreds of personnel stationed in the UK and overseas. Our staff continue with their dedicated mission to save lives in the channel whilst working with our French and other international partners to ensure the criminals responsible face the full extent of the law."